Welcome to the Game of Risk, everyone. I'm your host, OliveXC, a top player at this game. Back at you with some Yorb Advanced Progressive Capitals. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the legendary split map Yorb right here. Split map right through this territory in the Cascades. We're going to cap here right in the center of all of it. We're going to try to take and hold the Dinaric Alps and then look to expand like outwards. We could have capped down on Egypt, but there was a high chance of someone will be capping here. Someone caps here, and then we're stuck in the middle where there's almost no opportunity or chance for us to win. And let's go. Carter resubscribes. Thank you so much, Carter. Thank you, Carter. Much appreciated. All right, so green's going for the bottom part of the board. And unfortunately, we got hit twice. Third's like the worst position to be in EU caps because you have the highest chance of like only getting five. It is what it is, though. As long as we get our bonus, we can be in a good location. So that's what we're going to do. We have a 7 on capital, which is super safe. And it looks like pink has some like back capital over here, and they're looking to hold Spain that way. We'll have to watch pink a bit as they look to move out from France and could potentially like go into us. But pink sees our capital, so they should be wanting to leave us alone right now. I don't see white anywhere, which is really surprising because we have... Okay, there's white. So white's capped back here. Is white in Italy? But this does mean that green is going to have to focus on the white player. People are fighting for this area of the board, and that's good news for us. And, okay. What does yellow do now? Yellow's trying to slow roll something. As for what, we don't know. We do need another bonus for ourselves. I'm thinking the best one to go for would be Germany. Yeah, I guess he is. He must be coming from down here in Rome, Naples, Sardinia, probably. I'm expecting green to be making some attacks now in West Africa to try to hold that bonus. Because green is getting 9. No, green's taking it simple right now. Okay. That's fine. In our case, we're going to be making one attack here like this. We're going to give a fist pound to yellow. Say we're not attacking you. And then just going back. Again, I really expect someone to be here. Like pink is getting 10. Pink has Spain, like we were aware of. I don't expect to be holding Germany, but it was like the easiest and safest thing for us to go for. And it looks like pink's pushing for Orient now. Is pink possibly capped here and they just look to take Spain on their first move? That is a possibility. With white getting 6, I don't think they're long for this world. In a split map scenario like this, somebody is going to be getting overpowered very quickly. Acting on the moment is going to be like really important. It looks like yellow's given up. Pink is going for all the bonuses. Well, pink's going for something, that's for sure. It doesn't really seem like anybody's going for the top part of the board at all. With yellow now out of our crosshairs, we have the potential to be making a move. Like, green's just getting 9. Spacing with 100 bits. Thank you so much, my good sir.
Good evening, Olive.
Yeah, like, remember, white's still down here. Pink is still attacking, like, down here. We're not trying to go for the bottom. Our strategy is to try to be going, like, for the top. So I'm placing all on capital here. Let's see what's down over this side. Ooh, there's pink's capital. Yum. And there's purple. Okay. I do think we had to take that. Pink's capital is way too overpowered not to be going for. Purple may take our capital in the middle, but I think that's overall like a okay. Pink can roll that, but that's a very unlikely roll to succeed. You need, they take it, purple can just take it back otherwise. Yeah. So yeah, yeah. Yep, now they went to 5v3. Nope, that's a strong capital, man. We still have two capitals right now. I do think that attack on pink was very worthwhile. I think it was a really good move for us to be doing that. Our one concern now is if purple chooses to blast us. If the purple player does not blast us, we can look to refortify our area, and like we can be okay. It's going to come down to purple and what they want to do here. Let's see. Purple just gets 7. Oh, as long as purple doesn't break our bonus. If we can get the bonus and hold it for just one turn, we're okay. Good, good, good. Good, purple. Go for those bonuses. Attack the pink territories a little bit. That's so solid. That's so good for our game, man. And I don't think there's any way that green attacks us, because green's going for the bottom part of the board. They're fighting against the white player. So green is eventually going to be a menace. So basically green, white, and pink are all on the bottom side of the board. We just have to basically make this a 12, place the rest down here. We need to just cleave out the, and we give a fist pound to purple. We just make this an 8. Pink is still getting 8. They want to roll 12v12, they can. That's almost 0% odds. They can go through Spain and break our bonuses again, but we have an 8 on capital now. And pink is instead just chilling. White now has 8. I'm guessing white took the yellow player capital, and now they're basically in a conflict against the green player. So I'm expecting the pink player is basically out of this game. My only real enemy right now that I have to worry about is the purple player. So if I can knock purple out from the top side of the board, I can like take this game. Like purple's getting 11 right now, but purple's overall been relatively passive. If purple even breaks one bonus, I'm fine with that. If purple breaks multiple bonuses, I might have to shift my focus to them. But if purple just wants to take a couple of things, yeah, they're just chilling. Purple's like not that good. They're just chilling right here. They just want to hold like a little bit of bonuses and play like silently and passively. So I'm just going to blast pink and knock them out of Spain now. Once pink king is out of Spain, they're only getting 3 per turn. We can just like completely crush them. Because we still need to be saving, because green eventually must be going into us. But with this, we're now basically going in here. Okay, that's pink. We just got to hit that. Got to hit that right away because they were about to blast us. Actually, probably did not need to do that. We probably could have like just went on capital. Okay, we got a little overzealous there. Or we probably could have slow rolled that. Okay, we got a little overzealous. Pink trades in. So what's pink doing? Why do they go up that way? What? They're attacking purple? What? I just blasted pink and then pink chose to do that? What? So I fully acknowledge I made a mistake.
That was one heck of a negative roll, Kekweight.
How negative was that roll when I hit them? That's not horrible. That's actually pretty normal. White, green. Yeah, white and green are all kind of fighting for the bottom. It's only purple and I up top, but purple's not very good.
Purple card skip, huh?
They did card skip. Interesting. Okay. Like, we're fine with that. They're one turn away from getting Russia. What we really need to do, because green's still, like, still getting 10, we need to clear out the green player from France, because I think that's their last position. Then they're stuck on the bottom of the board. And that's going to force them to go into white. Then, because it looks like pink got cleared out. Now green realizes, oh snap, that's a big boy stack right there. We got to watch the big boy stack. So with that, what we got to be doing now is clear out green. Then we're going to be knocking out pink. That's a good roll. Now we're getting the good rolls that we need. And with 2 18s on capital, controlling this whole board on the split map, Europe, like, this is such a good setup right now. Pink did nothing this turn. Okay. So our focus is going to be the purple player now. Purple's going to have one turn to do something. Yeah, purple's just being way too passive. They're making mistakes. They really should have been much more aggressive taking territory like me, because we're the only ones fighting for the top of the board. White and green are on the bottom. Pink is basically dead. And white's now, like, going into green. Like, purple's just getting 12. They are going to have one trade in here. We have no trade in, but we don't really need one right now. We're really safe. Yeah, and you can see, like, purple is, they're just being way too passive. They're just trying, like, to hold their bonuses down, like this. If I let them hold Russia, they're going to be getting too strong, though, now. Yeah, purple should not be being a homie right now. I think it's a mistake for purple to be acting like that. How much should we get? Like, 33? Yeah, we're going into purple now. I think this is all of the pink player as well. Yep. That's triggering a trade-in for us, which is amazing. Yep, that's a nice trade-in. We're just going to be blasting purple more. They are holding Russia, though. They left all of those troops down like that. They left everything off capital right there. Are you kidding me? I guess I should have left troops down like that, but they could have left, like, a bigger stack down here, like, as well in Kharkiv. Still, we got the first mover strike on them. And looks like white's going in to try to break, to try to prevent us from holding and taking everything. Still, though, purple is not good. They just basically wasted a lot right there. Although purple, getting 14, they can still do a lot here. This is a very tenuous situation, but we did the right move doing the first mover strike against them. Let's see how much they do and how much they push. They should have break us here. We were a dick to them. Looks like they're just taking over Spain. Because what we have to knock white out and we have to break purple. Now, where do they leave their stack? That yellow six should be the last spot of the yellow, by the way. For one card, I think it's worth it. We're getting 13 still. I think we just let purple take the one card if they want to. We're going to let them hold Spain. We really can't stop that. We're going to knock white out of here because white was aggressively recognizing that we're a threat because we're actually doing shit. Small mistake there. Not a big deal. Next turn, we'll knock out yellow because then we do get the trade in. White is nowhere near the top of the board. They must be attacking the green player now. So now my only enemy is purple, who frankly has not shown a lot of strength this game. Purple is going to be getting one bonus and attacking. The danger is with purple, green not trading, white not trading in. There's a potential that green will trade in and then kill white, get their trade in again, and then blast us. Purple's still getting 11 right now. This is a very still tenuous situation, but we're on 69 troops, guys. With the power of 69, we can do a lot here. Purple does trade in. Let's see how much they attack. We'll be getting a trade in back, though. We'll be getting at least like 8 or 9 troops, probably, given purple's attacking speed. This is a really good game right now. Purple is also not breaking our bonuses. Okay, now they're breaking our bonuses. This is a mistake. What you need to be doing is breaking bonuses of your opponent, not taking your own. Because if I get a lot of troops, I just blast purple harder. We're still holding one bonus. Now let's see, does green kill the white player? White should probably be dying here. If white dies, we're in a lot of trouble. White's alive. That's so good for our game. So now we're going to trade in here. White could have... We're going to make this a 28 so we don't lose that. We're going to place the rest down here like this. And now we're going to go in. This should be all of what yellow. Yep. That's a card for us now. And we're going to aggressively attack. Purple sucks. We're testing their mechanics. They needed to do something about this. Purple cannot have a set here. And they're only getting, I think, one. They have an 8 here and an 11. We have a set here as well. This is so good for our game, guys. Because white and green are attacking. As long as green does not die here, and we hold our 28 down, we're completely fine. 3 out of 6. Okay, that's a big move. Does green die here? Because purple's now just getting 5. Purple cannot have a trading because they card skipped. Deaths are at 40. So we could potentially look to knock out purple here. From the top, and then have like a Giga Chat hold here at half the board. And then we have the ultimate reverse honeypot going on. People think you're fighting for the bottom honeypot. No, I just took the top. And our big stack here is open. And purple opened up the stack. We just have to take out these two territories here. And then we are completely fine. Purple has like nothing left on capital either. And green's just getting 3. I just don't know if green... Yeah, green trades in on 3. Oh my gosh. Watch leaders to go down to 2 out of 6. Yes. Oh my goodness. Green is now pounding the white player. This game is absolutely bananas. Does leader go up to 3 out of 6? Does white... die here. White is dead. Holy cow. We're still getting 36 here. Absolutely, we're trading in right now. We want to guarantee the kill on the purple player. So 6 here to take this out. Everything else here, we use our 8 because that way we're able to use up all of their troops as efficiently as possible. Also attack here. Extra troop. Then we attack here. Good roll. And now the purple player is eliminated. We get 3 cards, even had to trade it on 3. Holy cow. And guys, we don't need to do anything right now. Yeah, the green player won the honeypot. But we have the reverse half-map domination. Greed trades in right here. But they can only hit us, ladies and gentlemen. They cannot do anything. Even with 23 troops right here, I have more than them. 66 troops per turn. We absolutely trade in here. And we're just going to take this a little slow. Green could have like a 90. On capital right now. We don't want to open them up. I'm tripling their count right now, so there's no reason for me to push it. I'm also the only one able to get cards at the moment. Slow and steady. And we have a set here. Now it's going to be safe for us to go in and attack the green player. Because now we have a huge overwhelming lead. The most green can have is something like 150. And we have more than double that. 145? Exactly as I expected. And now we got a 100% roll. They could have something else now. We're just going to wait one turn and then take them out. And here you go, guys. If you're enjoying this content, please consider subscribing and following me on Twitch. Good game and well played. This is OliveXC signing off.